think Smith's up to something.
No?
It's just a feeling.
This factory project has caused nothing but trouble. The sooner it's cancelled, the better.
I'll see you later, Pat.
All right, everyone move out to dinner.
The best thing about all this extra dough we're getting is that we get it in...
It's going to depend on Gail's attitude. If she makes a good impression on the judge, it'll help a great deal.
Oh, I just wish I hadn't got so involved. What can you do?
Exactly what you did. Good night.
Good night.
Oh, Vera, this trial of Gail Summers is tomorrow. Look, I won't be able to go to the factory.
Well, so who'll be going?
Well, Sue Meadows. I think it's her turn.
Oh, don't worry. I'll do it. I'll tell her in the morning.
I thought you hated the place.
I do, but she's just had two double shifts there.
Vera, I only said I think B is up to something.
Well, it'll be a good chance to find out, won't it?
Hello?
Erica, it's Andrew.
Oh, I was hoping it would be you. I was going to call you, as a matter of fact.
Why?
Well, Meg Jackson told me about the accident at the factory. Is Mr. Talbot all right?
Well, he was pretty shaken up, but he's all right now.
Did Smith say anything at the time?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, did she have anything against him? Was there any incident before the accident?
Good heavens, you've got a nasty mind.
Unfortunately, it's part of my job.
Well, stop worrying. The machine short-circuited while Vince was working on it. Nothing more, nothing less.
Was Smith near at the time?
Look, it was an accident. Don't be so suspicious.
With Smith, I have reason to be.
All right, Governor. Now, let's talk about something else. When am I going to see you?
Tomorrow night?
Goodness, I am getting forward, aren't I?
Right. I think it's wonderful. Let's have dinner.
Oh, somewhere quiet.
Such as?
What about here?
Good grief. Can you cook as well?
I'll have you know, my good man, I am an excellent cook.
I'll look forward to that.
So will I. Bye.
Bye.
How are you all set?
Don't know why I'm bothering, really.
Oh, neither do I, then, if that's your attitude.
Well, Captain Barton thinks I might get a bond, but everyone else...
Now, the only bit of fight I've seen out of you is when you stood up to us the other day.
Yeah, well, Doreen's been telling me about people who get their hopes
up. Doreen. Sure, it's risky to get your hopes up, but it's far worse to lie down and die. Still, that's up to you, I suppose. I just thought I'd drop by and say good luck.
Thanks.
You reckon old Meadows was joking at breakfast?
What about Vera coming to the factory today?
Could be trouble if she does, with all this extra stuff Reynolds wants us to do.
We'll just have to be careful, that's all.
Oh, well, if the extra dough doesn't come through, I could just go back to making me book.
You ever heard of making book with two broken arms, Margot? I've told you before, anything that's a threat to the work project is out.
Well, what about your little campaign with Vince? All this extra work?
It's not a threat to the work project.
Why not?
Because I say it's not, that's why.
Come on, you lot. Let's go.
Thought you hated the factory, Vera.
It happens we're short-staffed, Smith. Come on. Well, don't hang about, Summers. I'm sure there's plenty to do in your cell.
Oh, bum, what's a gate doing shut?
Miss Bennett locked it again.
Oh, that'll be right. Vera gets a terrific kick out of making things hard for people. I just took Judah Brecky and she's ready to go up the walls.
Lizzie, how long have you been in here, in Wentworth?
Years and years. I've seen them come and I've seen them go. I've seen them knife, I've seen them chucked off the roof. Riots. Suppose it relieves the boredom.
I really don't think I want to be in here.
Nobody wants to be in here, love. except me, but I'm getting nothing in my old age. Know what it's going to be next Tuesday?
Me birthday.
Happy birthday, Lizzie.
I used not think very much about me birthday, but now I do. I've got these people on the outside. Me daughter and me granddaughter. Well, sort of me daughter. And I was just thinking, wouldn't it be bonzer if I could get out for half a day, and what a nice present that'd be.
Reckon they'll let you out?
I've asked Captain Barton. I reckon he'll swing it.
Oh, he's a wonderful man, isn't he?
All men are wonderful when you've been in here for a while, at least most of them are.
What are you doing, Lizzie?
Waiting for you. That old Bennett, she can't look at a gate without locking it. Strange, isn't it? Do you know that she's got 15 locks on her front door so she can unlock every one of them in the mornings?
Come on, Lizzie, on your way.
Good luck in the court, love.
Thanks.
Come on, Summers. Time to go.
Good morning, ladies.
Morning, Mr. Reynolds.
Morning. I thought you'd have had enough of us by now, Miss Bennett.
Well, we got rid of Burke. She was the key to our problem. Mm.
They must be pretty boring stuck in that tea room all day.
Oh, I don't know. At least a person can relax for 5 minutes. Everything okay? Mm. Well, we'll make ourselves a cup of coffee. Mr. Reynolds.
Miss Bennett. You think she'll make it difficult?
We'll just have to be careful, that's all.
She doesn't seem suspicious.
Could be an act. How's Vince?
Oh, he's fine. He's working in the other section at the moment. Look, about that extra work, I've got an order in and it's rather urgent. How soon do you think we can make a start?
We could give it a go today. Just small quantities, though.
Right, I'll see you in about an hour.
Remember, one garment at a time to start with. If we get sprung, I'll invent an excuse.
Right.
And what first made you aware, Mrs. Jackson, that all might not be well?
I heard children screaming, and then slaps.
Objection, Your Honor. Mrs. Jackson had no way of knowing the sound she heard was slaps.
Sustained.
Might I put it to you another way? You heard sounds which appeared to be slaps.
That's correct.
What happened next?
Well, Mrs. Summers came to my door in a terrible state. She said that Jason was unconscious. He was rushed to hospital.
And you subsequently saw extensive bruising on the child?
That's right.
In addition to the sound of slaps, did you hear anything else that might indicate a state of tension next door?
Well, there was often children crying and arguments.
Did you hear Mrs. Summers actually yelling at the children?
Yes.
And you formed the opinion that the child was being beaten?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mrs. Jackson.
Maybe Vera's getting to like the life. She hasn't stuck her nose out all morning.
Oh, somebody gave her a kid's crossword. Can't get past the first clue.
Here's the sample. Kay's getting the material now.
Okay, we'll still stick you one at a time, though.
Well, that's up to you. Kay's worked out a story to explain why the stuff's here.
Hazel Crowe wanted to know where all this was going.
Who's she?
The union rep.
Well, it's none of Hazel's business.
Well, she seems to think it is. They know this lot are being paid less than them, and they're worried about their jobs.
I'll talk to her. No one's job's being threatened, and she knows it.
Yes, well, I'd be careful if I were you.
Well, you leave Hazel to me. The one we have to worry about, Miss Bennett.
Good morning, Miss Bennett. Stretching your legs.
This is nice. What is it?
I'm making up some samples.
Oh, you're very versatile.
Well, this machine is vacant. Okay if I use it, Mr. Reynolds?
Oh, should be safe enough. What do you think, Miss Bennett?
That's fine. I'll leave you to it.
She doesn't suspect anything?
Doesn't look like it. But we'll still stick to one at a time and keep them out of sight, you lot.
Right, one down and one to go. I'll go and sort out Hazel.
And what do you do for a living, Mr. Summers?
I work in a factory.
And you do lots of overtime, so you're away from home quite a bit?
Yeah, that's right. Well, we couldn't get by on just my wages.
Quite so. And you had no idea your wife was beating the children?
Well, how would I? Anyway, two of them weren't even my kids. But I did my best for all of them.
Did you have any reason to fear that the children were being inadequately cared for?
Well, she wasn't too crash hot on the housework. I mean, I know she's my wife, but I think she'd rather have been chatting to the neighbours than taking care of the kids.
Objection, Your Honour. If Mr. Summers is working so much of the time, how does he know?